I'm Jennifer Beeston with Guaranteed Rate Mortgage, and today I want to talk to you about closing costs. Closing costs in California, to be specific. So whenever people are thinking about buying a house, they're always thinking about how much they need to save for the down payment, but they're rarely thinking about how much they have to save for closing costs. Some people don't even know there are closing costs. I've had clients from out of state that when they're buying into California have heart attacks almost when I tell them how much their closing costs are gonna be. And it's not because it's so much more expensive here, it's just because the seller does not traditionally pay everything here. Some states, the seller pays more than they do in California. So as a home buyer, you need to be prepared with your down payment and with closing costs. So the rule of thumb is traditionally about 3% up to $350,000 as the purchase price, okay? Once you get above $350,000, you're usually looking at between 2 and 3% of the purchase price. The higher the purchase amount, the lower that percentage goes. So in ballpark terms, if I have a client who's buying a house between $100,000 and $400,000, I'm gonna guess that their closing costs are gonna be between $6,000 and $9,000, okay? And the reason it's gonna be that much is because the fees that you're gonna have during closing is you're gonna have a lender fee, which isn't the biggest one. You're gonna have title and escrow. They determine their fees based off of the purchase price. So if you're buying a more expensive home, your title and escrow fees are gonna be higher, okay? So if you get a sheet from a lender or someone with an estimate, and let's say it's for a $400,000 house, but then you buy a $500,000 house, it's gonna change, okay? So title and escrow is based off the purchase price. In addition, you're gonna have the cost of an appraisal. Now, if you're just getting a single family home appraisal and the purchase price is under $1 million, I would expect in California, this is for owner occupied, for it to be between $450 and $600 on the high end, okay? If you're buying an investment property, I would expect it to be between $500 and $700. The reason it would be more is because with an investment property, we have to do rental surveys and that makes the appraiser charge us more. So budget for the appraisal. And then you're also gonna have things like an impound account. If you're putting down less than 20%, you have to have an impound account. What that means is that the bank will collect your property taxes and your insurance monthly with your payment. Some people like to do this regardless of how much they put down. Now, the trick with how this increases your closing cost, it's not because there's a fee to do this, but it's because they need a cushion. So for instance, if your first payment is in July, but your taxes are due in November, the bank's gonna need a cushion, otherwise they don't have enough money to make that tax payment for you. So if you have an impound account at play, that does increase your closing costs. It's not closing fee, but it is a closing cost. And there's not a set number on that because that's gonna vary based off of when you close. And as a lender, we always advise you, okay, if you close in this month, we think it will be approximately 4 or 5 months of taxes we're collecting up front, or two, or whatever it is. So that's a moving target that can be a little bit tough to budget for. So if you're nervous, I would say, and let's say you're over 500,000, budget 2.5%, okay, for closing costs. The other types of fees you'll have is certain counties, the buyer pays transfer taxes. Some counties, they don't. You're gonna wanna ask your realtor what you're responsible for. In some counties, it's really easy to get the seller to split title and escrow with you. In other counties, it's not. So there's no one set rule in California for who pays what. Everything's a negotiation. But as a buyer, especially with inventory being as tight as it is and as many multiple offers, you wanna be able to pay for all the closing costs if necessary. So budget between 2 to 3%. If you're buying a $100,000 house, the 2 to 3% is not gonna work. You're really gonna need to budget, I would say, $5,000 to $6,000. Even though it's only $100,000, you'd be surprised how these things add up. An appraiser, for example, doesn't charge you less because the house is less. So just a good rule of thumb, 2 to 3%, save for your closing costs in addition to your down payment. If you have questions, if you wanna talk about loans, get pre-approved, give me a call. My team and I love doing loans. Clearly, why else would I do this? You can get me at 707-478-0637. And once again, I'm Jennifer Beeston with Guaranteed Rate Mortgage. Thank you.